So today we'll be analyzing a company called Rain Industries Limited. So Rain Industries is one of the world's largest producer of calcined petroleum coke, coal tar pitch, and other high-quality advanced material. Rain continues to grow through capacity expansions and mergers and acquisitions across the world. Rain operates in three business verticals, that is carbon, advanced materials, and cement. So we'll go through each one of them, like in carbons, which all the products they manufacture and what are they doing in advanced materials and their cement plants. Basically, cement, they are just in India. Okay, so in the carbon vertical, so they are the one of the largest producers of calcined petroleum coke, and also they have a huge capacity of coal tar pitch also. So if you look at it here, manufacturing facilities in 8 countries across 3 continents. Basically, they are in Europe, US, and Asia, that is in India. Okay, so production capacity of 2.1 million tons of CPC and 4 million tons of cement, 1.5 million tons of coal tar pitch, and then specialty chemicals. So we'll go through them one by one. Okay. So CPC. So what is CPC? It is calcined petroleum coke that is used in making of anodes for aluminium, steel, and titanium industries. Okay. So if you're bullish on the whole aluminium sector, so aluminium basically is going to be used for all your EVs, right? So the chassis of all the EVs is going to be made from aluminium since it is strong and has a very light weight. And also, if you are really bullish on the steel cycle, then to make those anodes, right, then you need CPC. And also the titanium smelting industry. So that is usually used in toothpaste and all those stuff. Okay, the white color thing. So its facilities are in, so one is in India and rest all of them are in US. So for the CPC, right, most of them are in US. And you know, recently the US government, they released a package for this infrastructure. So this should really help Rain Industries in the coming years. So most of these countries, to bring back growth, right, they are going to spend huge amount on infrastructure because that is the main way to get back growth in the economy. So because of that, rain should really benefit. Okay, so that is about CPC. And coming to coal tar pitch, so coal tar pitch, it is also used as a binder for aluminium industry carbon anodes, graphite anodes, specialty graphite, and refractory material. So again, this caters to the aluminium as well as the steel industry. As you know, graphite electrodes, refractory, all these cater to the steel sector. So again, this particular product is catering to both these aluminium and steel thing. So if you are bullish on both of them, that is aluminium and steel, then whatever Rain is doing, right, it is going to cater to both of them. So higher chances of this particular company outperforming rather than just going with the steel thing or with the aluminium companies. It is better to play this particular one, which has an exposure to both of them. So where all the plants are, that is, they have it in Germany, Belgium, Canada, and Russia. Okay, so that is about their coal tar pitch. And then they are into some of these specialty chemicals also, aromatic chemicals and stuff. And the cement plant, which is in just South India, one is in Telangana and one is in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so this is about their carbon product. Now coming to the advanced materials. So what are advanced materials? So advanced materials are those which are better than the conventional material. So let's say you are using something that is heavy and bulky or not that strong. Advanced materials are going to replace all your conventional materials in the years to come because they might be eco-friendly, or they might be lighter in weight, have better performance. So because of all that, slowly the world is going to move to all these advanced materials. Okay, so Rain is a global leader and innovator in the production of advanced materials through the innovative downstream transformation of a portion of our carbon output, petrochemicals and other raw materials into high value, eco-friendly raw materials that are critical to the specialty chemicals, coating, construction, automotive, petroleum and several other global industries. So it has its advanced material production facilities in Germany, Canada and Netherlands. So almost 25% of Rain's consolidated turnover is from this particular product. Okay, so they are in resins, engineering products, petrochemicals and naphthalene derivatives. So facilities in Germany, Netherlands cannot. So for the future, what they are exactly doing are, so coal tar based resins for rubber tire application in electric cars. So as you all know, in the next coming years, maybe 10-15, most of the IC engine cars are going to be converted to electric cars, right? And then a colorless resin for tape and book binding. Another important thing here, specialty coating that improves energy storage of lithium ion batteries. So as you all know, lithium ion batteries are going to replace all these lead batteries most probably. So they are into that as well. And a new generation of eco-friendly resins with water miscibility to be used in waterborne coatings and adhesive formulation with reduced volatile organic emulsion. So all these, the Rain Industries are working on in the R&D this thing, and slowly these should start gaining traction and also start yielding good profits. Usually these kind of businesses are high margin business for the company. And then the cement plant. So cement plant is just in India. One is in Telangana and another one is in Andhra Pradesh. So this is about the business overview of the company. Now we'll look at the fundamentals of this company. So the market cap is around 6,000 crores, whereas the enterprise value is around 13,000 crores. So that means this company has a debt of almost around 7,000 crores. So if you take out the cash equivalent, the real debt on the this thing is around 7,000 crores. So ROC is quite okay. Here, what you need to look at is the book value. So the book value is 165 and the current price is 176. So what is book value? Let's say the company today sells all its assets and pays back all its liabilities. Whatever amount that is going to be left with the company, right? If they are going to distribute that amongst its shareholders, then each one of us is going to get 165 rupees per share. So it is one of those bets where you are buying something for its book value, hardly 10 rupees higher than that. So if you look at the sales of the company, so on an enterprise value of 13,000 crores, this is actually almost having the same sales. That is around 11,000 crores of sales. And recently, in the last quarter, right? Yeah. So the sales have again started to go up. The operating profits have, margins have improved to 20%. And then the net profit was around 206. Although here it looks higher, but that was on account of other income. So if you ignore this particular thing, right? There is a definite improvement on quarter on quarter thing. Right. So this, as I've told you, for cyclical companies, you don't look at the compounded sales or the profit growth, as we are just starting the cycle, and the cycle should last at least another 1 or 2 years. So look, coming to the cash flow from operations. So this company has around 2000 crores of CFO, and most of it is, as you can see here, going into reinvesting for the capex that they are doing, right? Almost 1000 crores every year they are putting it back into capex. And although this looks this is a negative, most of it is for interest payments, which is slowly coming down. As you can see, interest paid that is coming down slowly as the interest rates are also going down. So they haven't really borrowed more money here or in this particular year. So they plan to kind of deleverage their balance sheet in this particular year. So we'll talk about that also. So we'll now look at their CapEx plans. So the CapEx plans, right? The company's vertical shaft CPC plant at Visakhapatnam is on track and is expected to start its operation in current quarter, that is in Q1 of 2020. And another thing that is hydrogenated hydrocarbons resin plant in Germany is also going to start from Q2 of 2020. So these guys, they run their financial year on their calendar year. So Q2 means we are already in Q2. So this should have started already. Right? This particular thing is going to be used for waterproofing applicants such as food packaging, diapers, and other stuff. So here, the company clarified that it is not supplying CPC to China, hence the shutdown of aluminium plants in China is not going to impact them. Okay, and they have recently come up with a new thing that is ACP. So this ACP is going to be combined with blended with CPC to aluminium smelters. So that also they have started, and its India ACP plant is expected to be commissioned by H2 of 2020, while the one in the US is expected to start operations in Q2 of 2020. So all these are going to come on stream very soon, and that is again going to boost their top line as well as their bottom line. So this is related to their CapEx. And also recently what they said, from 3.8 debt to equity, they plan to bring it down to 3 in this particular financial year. Okay, so all this should be good for the company in the years to come. And now looking at the chart of this company, it has been kind of moving in this particular channel. So it kind of tested this resistance and came down. So once it takes out this resistance, the next one would be around 230, and then it would be all the way up to 405. So by the year end, right, so by December of 2021, that is in another 7 odd months, if it maintains this particular channel, then it should head to something like 340, which would be at least double from these levels. And that is the base case scenario. Or in the best case scenario, it can go up to something like 540 or 590 levels. That would be 3 times of what its current price now. Okay. So if you are kind of bullish on the aluminium or the steel or even the advanced material thing, which is going to be huge in the coming days, then you can take a bet on this particular company. Okay, thank you.